lime sludge, paper sludge, etc. from their respective experts who are working here at CSIR CBRI. And at today's lecture, I will discuss something more about the sustainable lightweight building product technologies from waste, specifically quota stone waste and fly ash. So the brief outline of the presentation will be, firstly I will discuss about the introduction of stone, the types of stone on the basis of geology and chemical composition. Then I will discuss why we need to research in the perspective of sustainability. Then I will discuss about the lightweight concrete, its basics, its fundamentals. Then I will discuss about experimental program, mixed design, advantage to use CFC block, technologies that has been developed by our team here in the supervision of Dr. Mrs. Rajni Lakhani ma'am. She is head of our organic building materials group. And then I will three, four slides about the ongoing research work that we are doing here about LISA concrete, lightweight expanded clay aggregate concrete, and then the future scope. So as an introductory part, as we know that the stones, various kinds of stones have been utilized by humans and other humanoids for different kinds of purposes, either in the form of aggregates, coarse aggregate, fine aggregates, sculptures, or to use them as dimensional stone, as tiles, like we use in the household, quota stone tiles, marble stone tiles, etc. And on the basis of geological mode of formation, these stones are classified in the three part, that is igneous, metamorphic and sedimentary rock. On the basis of chemical composition, they are classified as crystalline, not amorphous, crystalline, siliceous, calcareous and argillaceous rocks. Majorly in India, the stone production, the stone produced in India are, you can see here in the right bottom chart, that majorly marble stone is produced up to 50%, followed by granite and other kind of stone such as limestone or quota stone and sandstone in the various parts of India. On the basis of production globally, India ranks the largest producer of natural stone, and it accounts for nearly 50% of world's natural stone production. Basically, limestone, as a brief introduction I want to tell you, basically limestone is a sedimentary rock, and which contains typically 70% by mass of calcium carbonate. Typically, if in many form of limestone, some amount of silica or magnesium carbonate is also there. If the incorporation of SiO2 is there, suppose ranging from 30% to 40% or 45%, which will reduce the overall calcium carbonate content, and that limestone is called low grade limestone. And the annual production of limestone in India is about 238 million ton, out of which 10 million ton is quota stone. Basically, quota stone is a kind of low grade limestone. I am more emphasizing here about the quota stone, because further the research work that I will discuss will be about low grade limestone, and this data is taken from Center for Development of Stone, CDOS, the report that has been published in the year 2017. Limestone is, as we know, that limestone is primarily raw material in the manufacturing of OPC, so it is vitally extracted from the quarries, mines, and therefore the generation of waste from limestone is higher than that the others. Now here it is a kind of limestone, but it is low grade, as I have discussed in the slide number 4. So the processing of limestone, either it is by chainsaw or diamond wire cutting or during polishing from quarries, the major amount of waste, that is 50% of amount of waste, is generated annually, which is annually about 4.5 million ton. Disposal of this waste causes various kind of environmental pollution. लाइक एयर पॉल्यूशन, वाटर पॉल्यूशन एंड लैंड पॉल्यूशन, एंड ऑल्सो इट 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 अफेक्ट्स द लॉन्जिटिविटी ऑफ द रिजाइडिंग पीपुल्स हु आर लिविंग इन द इन द नियर बाई एरिया द एट इन ऑन विच दैट दैट स्टोन पॉलिशिंग स्लरीज आर डम्प्ड. सो द इंडस्ट्री ऑल्सो सफर टू स्टोर दिस काइंड ऑफ वेस्ट. दैट्स वाई यू कैन सी हियर इन द इन बोथ फिगर दे जस्ट डम्प्ड इन द ओपन एग्रीकल्चरल फील्ड एंड विच कॉजेज द डिफरेंट काइंड्स ऑफ इन्वायरमेंटल पॉल्यूशन. सो इन डिटेल द प्रॉब्लम्स अकर्ड आर एज द सेटल्ड स्लरी इज पम्प्ड आउट इन टू द एडजस्टेंट एग्रीकल्चरल लैंड्स विच डिवास्टेटिंग द फर्टिलिटी ऑफ दैट एग्रीकल्चरल लैंड बाई चॉकिंग द ओवरऑल पोरोसिटी एंड डिक्रीजेज द न्यूट्रिशन the nutrition value of that agricultural land. And these microfine slurry particles having D90 size of 200 micron and D50 size of 5 micron chalk the drains, as I have discussed, in the rainy season, create dust nuisance, affect productivity of fertile land due to decreased porosity. And due to this long-term deposition, finer particle blocks the flow regime which affect the groundwater table, and thus overall underground water availability reduces down. As you can see here, these left two figures shows the dumping sites of marble slurry in the Udaipur region, and in the right bottom you can see that the RSPM level, that is respiratory suspended particulate matter. This is RSPM which we can inhale. I am not talking about the particle that we can't inhale. It is given in the rest of two figures, but I am discussing here in this graph the RSPM level, which is almost 200% times more. The below that line is the standard value that is it should be, but at different place you can see here it is here you can see here that top 180. The level is 180, and here you can see the optimum level is 60. So it is just double. It is just 200 times more. So now I will discuss the work done that is carried by many researchers in Agrawal, Topku, and Gaisoglu. These researchers have used Kota stone slurry, marble slurry, limestone slurry, and they have substituted cement in the fraction of ranging from 0 to 100. You can see here they have replaced clay, some of their researcher replaced cement, and they have developed concrete mortar, sand lime bricks, binder have also developed, and that is also known as ALPM, that was developed here at CBRI, activated lime pozzolana mix, in the early 90s, and self compacted concrete has been also developed, and so forth. So overall, if we replace the sand with the stone slurry, any kind of stone slurry, whether it is marble or limestone or granite or sandstone, it will increase the strength attributes, whether it is compressive, tensile, it will increase the thermal resistance, abrasion resistance, shrinkage, cracking, etc. But if we replace the cement in the higher amount, more than say 20%, it will at the same time it will decrease the strength, thermal resistance, heat of hydration will be decreased of course, and the setting time will be reduced because it forms the nucleation sites during in the cement composite mix during hydration, and workability of course due to its higher fineness, the workability will also be decreased. So the need for research, why we have developed the lightweight concrete blocks from stone, because as we know that India is the second largest producer of bricks in the world, and makes in India annually the production of brick is about 200 billion, and which uses 400 million ton of good quality soil every year, and number of brick producing unit, either it is vertical shaft clean or high draft clean or any other clean, is more than 1 lakh, and burning of the fuel results in the greenhouse gas emission in the form of CO2, NOx, etc., and ashes, whatever generated from fuel, causes the various kind of environmental pollution, including air pollution majorly. So the replacement of stone powder waste as an aggregate or powder or dust with cement or aggregate in conventional concrete has improved. It has been seen that it improved the properties of hardened concrete, as I have already discussed. Therefore, lightweight concrete as a replacement of brick is developed, which was as per IS 218-5 Part 4. This code is about the lightweight concrete, which I will discuss further in brief. And we have evaluated different attributes, physico mechanical and chemical properties, in the terms of workability, compressive strength, strength performance factor. Strength performance factor is basically the ratio of strength and density, fresh properties, drying shrinkage, and microstructural characterization, etc. So basically, lightweight concrete, here you can see it can be used in the masonry unit or panels, and it is of two types: formed concrete and autoclave aerated concrete. The concept to generate the lightweight concrete or aerated concrete is completely different for both. For formed concrete, we use forming agent. The forming agent can be organic form or synthetic form. Natural or in the meaning of organic form is natural protein we can use, or soybean protein we can use. And the curing is just moist curing or air curing, ambient air curing. In industry, the industry uses mostly moist and air curing, not water curing. The region I will discuss in the further slides. And in the autoclave aerated concrete, chemical expansion agent like Al2O3, we use here it is written also aluminum powder we use, which reacts with calcium hydroxide and generate hydrogen gas, and the formation of bubble will be there. And after formation, here you can see also in the flow chart that after the forming of air bubble, we open the mold and then we cut the blocks in the standard size, and then that block is done autoclave curing, and then after curing they are shipped. So now my main emphasis in the further presentation will be cellular formed concrete, CFC. So I have used the mechanical aeration method, and the technique was preformed form. The form was formed before addition, before the mixing process. That it was not just like after adding the whole material, and then after adding the whole material, then after some time the formation of gas will be there. We have developed the form prior to the mixing in the mixer. And basically, formed concrete contains stable air or gas cells uniformly distributed in the mix. Note that it should be uniformly distributed. It was as per IS 2185 part 4. It possesses basically high flowability, having flow value more than 150, low self weight, minimum use of fine aggregate, and controlled low strength, excellent thermal and sound insulation properties. On the basis of grade, there are three kinds of CFC, that is A, B, C. And the A grade is used for load bearing purpose, having density range from 1200 to 1800, and the respective referred code is given as in the right column. For grade B, they discuss about the non load bearing structures. In the further slides, I will discuss about the CFC of grade B. And grade C discuss about the thermal insulation as an infill materials. So this is the previous research work done in CSIR CBRI starting from 1959 to 2018. This is the research paper published, and they are available on the online. And now also in our group we are doing comprehensively the research study regarding formed concrete, autoclave aerated concrete, and lightweight structural concrete. So in brief, I will tell you what experimental program we have followed. Firstly, we have collected the waste. We have identified the dumping site, that from where we should collect the slurry. It should not be so wet, because the wetness of the slurry affects the fresh property, workability, flowability, etc. of the end product. And then material characterization suitably from IS 383, 2386 part of 129, and then IS 8112, etc. We have done. And also we have determined the particle size analysis from laser particle size analyzer to see the packing density effect, how the slurry powder added affects the overall packing density. So we have done this also prior to mixed design, and then the unique mixed design methodology we have developed with 8 design steps. I will discuss briefly, very briefly, in the further slides. And that novel mixed design has been published also. And then we have developed the specimens of different size, ranging from 100 mm to blocks. You can see here that 400 by 200 by 200 mm. Then we have done curing. We have cut easily the developed end product. After cutting, we have done the physico-mechanical study, compressive, tensile, and flexural study. Then we have conducted microstructural morphological analysis. We have also seen coefficient of thermal expansion to see the behavior of cellular form concrete during fire. So we have done that also. Then after basic testing, we have finalized a few mixed proportions for the advanced characterization regarding SAM, XRD, TGDT, etc. So this is mixed design steps. Very briefly, I will tell you that what we have done. Because as we know that if we want to design the normal concrete, so we can use the code IS 10262. So, but for CFC, the IS code is not available, and for Indian condition, it was very difficult. So it take almost 6 to 7 months to design this mixed design, because it was it uses the different trials, also American standards, British standards, and then a final mixed design methodology by deriving a few formulas we have done. And then we have found that the error was the error in the compressive strength, and the dry density was below 5%, which is desirable also. So we have concluded this design that it is suitable, and if anyone wants to develop the lightweight concrete from the waste material, which is very fine, it doesn't imparts in any zone, like zone 1, 2, 3, 4, as you all are aware from IS 383, in which 4 kind of zone are given. So this slurry doesn't fit in any zone. So with this mixed design, we can develop lightweight concrete of suitable targeted density, whatever you have desire as per your need. We can develop the lightweight concrete. So firstly, what will you have to do? Firstly, you will set the targeted casted density, so which will be based on water cement ratio. Suppose you want to develop a lightweight concrete of targeted dry density of 1000, which is non load bearing. So you will set a targeted casting density 1200. Take it 1200 for each mixed proportion, and then you will take it value as x, which is initial parameter. Firstly, you will have to fix x value. Then you have to fix the form density, which should be in the range between 30 to 65 kg per meter cube, which is standard. You can't go below than that, because if you will develop a form with a form density of 20 kg per meter cube, it will have less form stability, and it will collapse with time before the setting of cement. Before the initial, more specifically I will say, before the initial setting of cement, which is 30 minutes. As you all are aware, the specification for OPC 43 grade, which is given in IS 8112. So it, for our case, we have taken we have taken the form density of 50 kg per meter cube, and for developing this we have done the trial by mixing foaming agents and water in the ratio of 120, 130 and 150. Then we have distributed solid weight. What solid we have taken? OPC we have taken. We have taken stone slurry, that is Kota stone slurry. You can call it as low grade limestone slurry because it contains less amount of calcium carbonate, and also it contains higher amount of silicon dioxide. Normally limestone contains approximately 2 to 3% of SiO2, but here low grade limestone or Kota stone contains about 35 to 40% of silicon dioxide. So that's why I am saying this limestone as low grade limestone. So then after that we have calculated total water, and which was calculated assuming water cement ratio ranging from 0.6 to 1.25. Then we have done the trials, and after trials we have done the regression analysis, and from that regression analysis and from some perturbation we have seen the effect of various kinds of solid materials on the volume of air. So after the empirical analysis we have developed this formula. The detail you can find in this paper which is published in the year of 2018. Then we have found the volume from volume of air and then weight, and then we have determined the amount of water in mortar based mix. What does it means, mortar based mix? Mortar based mix is the just mortar mix without foam. So we have subtracted the weight of foam, because the overall water cement ratio should be constant, otherwise it will affect the workability of CFC mix. And then we have, and if the stability of CFC mix is not stable, then the segregation of the green cellular form concrete mix will be there, like as we know in case of normal concrete. So at step 7, before casting, we have seen that whatever we have done, that is casting, curing, mixing times was standardized, although it is not mentioned here. And then we have checked for consistency and the achieved density ratio after 28 days. That suppose we have targeted for 1000, that and we are obtaining suppose 990 kg per meter cube after 28 days. So it is okay that we have 990 by 1000. So it is okay that we have our final density, real density is somehow near to that target. So it is okay. So we have determined the consistency and achieved density ratio for each mix. So we have taken two series. We have casted the mix proportion in two series. Series 1, series 2, denoted as S1 and S2. S1 means the density 1000 kg per meter cube. Hereafter I will nominate 1000 kg per meter cube density as S1. So and S2 as 800 kg per meter cube. In each series, whether it is S1 or S2, we have taken 5 phases, and the phases was with respect to the percentage replacement level of stone slurry with sand. The phases were nominated as P1, P2, P3, P4 and P5. So P1 was with respect, in P1 we have there was no replacement, that is 0% replacement level. In P2 25, P3 50 and so for 75 and 100. So two series S1, S2 and 5 phases P1 to P5. And for each phases we have taken 3 water cement ratio, as you can see here, 0.6, 0.7 and 0.8, which was on the basis of flowability, flow value. And we have determined the flow value from flow table test, and our flow value was fixed as 130, 150 and 170. and which was quite higher. As you know that for motor it is it ranges from 110 to 125, those who have conducted the test of flow table for motor. But here as I have mentioned that it is self flowable, so that's why the flow value was quite high than that of conventional motor mix. So here you can see that how the stone slurry affects the weight of foam. You just see the column. This is that blue one. That blue one. You can see as we increase the stone slurry, then the amount of foam, that is weight of foam, increases. Why? Why it was show? Because the incorporation of slurry collapse the formed bubble, because they are angular and they are so fine that they can penetrate and they can destabilize the foam generated. That's why we have added extra foam, and we have added the extra foam to target our achieved density ratio and consistency of green mix. So you can see here modified slurry, the amount of modified slurry is increasing, then the weight of foam and the volume of foam is also increasing. Then we have done casting and curing. Specifically, we have done the air curing and moist curing. Then we have conducted various kinds of physico-mechanical and chemical properties. We have determined the compressive strength, tensile strength and flexural strength, not strength. We have determined the performance, strength performance factor, which I will discuss in the upcoming slides. And we have determined the coefficient of thermal expansion. We have facility in our lab that is called Dilatometer, which can give you the CTE, that is alpha, and which is the major properties which should be major if anybody is studying the fire performance, or if anyone is doing the modeling of fire. So we have done that also at different temperatures. We have done also the thermal conductivity through transient state method, that is known as C-therm analyzer. We have determined the thermal diffusivity, effusivity and specific heat capacity. We have compared the these value with the brick also, and we have to see the influence of stone slurry on the hydration of cementitious system. We have seen the XRD and SAM also. So here I will tell you something about performance factor. I will tell you why we have determined the performance factor, not strength and density specifically. When you will read or when you will see the research paper regarding the conventional concrete having density of 2400 kg per meter cube, there you can see that the strength and density value is written separately. In practice they do not write the strength and the density as a ratio, because it is well known that normally the density of conventional concrete ranges from approximately 2300 to 2400 kg per meter cube. But in case of lightweight concrete, the density of lightweight concrete ranges from 300 to 1800 kg per meter cube. So it will be little bit confusing if anyone say the lightweight concrete is 2.5 MPa, but he or she should mention the density of that concrete also. So the combinedly we have denoted the strength and density in the ratio form, that is strength to density ratio, which is called performance factor for compressive strength, for flexural strength you can see here, and for tensile strength at 28 days. So what we have found is that slurry modifies the microstructure and packing density of the composites. Therefore the overall performance factor was more for 50% replacement of fine aggregate. And normally the in Indian code, in Indian code IS 2185 part 4, the value of performance factor for strength is given, not for flexural and tensile, but I have mentioned here. But the performance factor for compressive strength is given there is 350. So you can see here at 50% of replacement level, our value was 382, which is quite more than that. So it means this, that we can replace the slurry up to 50%, which is maximum optimal designed method which we can use to replace the fine aggregate with the slurry. And this is for S1. S1, this, that is for density 1000 kg per meter cube. For S2, that is for density 800 kg per meter cube, we can go for the same replacement level. And for S2, that is for 800 kg per meter cube, when you will see the IS code that I have mentioned already, IS 2185 part 4, you will see that the value is, the standard value is given 315, and here we have got 318 at percentage replacement level of 50%. So we have chosen, we have concluded that we can replace 50% of slurry with sand. Here you can see that we have conducted also image analysis. We have determined the aspect ratio. Aspect ratio is basically the ratio of major axis to minor axis. So we have seen that the aspect ratio for both kind of density, that is S1 and S2, as I have already mentioned, phase 3 is regarding for 50% of replacement level, and S1 is for 1000 kg per meter cube. So we have seen that aspect ratio was ranged from 0.95 to 1.50, and for for series 2 it was ranged from 0.90 to 1.62. We have also seen the average area voids to compare our theoretical entrained air voids, not entrained and entrapped air. So our main intention was to incorporate entrained air whose size ranges from 10 micron to 1 mm, and which are not quite harmful for concrete for durability perspective. But if you will see the effect of entrapped air, they are quite bigger than entrained air. As you normally do the casting, you can for normal concrete, you can see that many times there is the formation of entrapped air takes place, and the size ranges from 1 mm to 4 mm, 5 mm, and they are quite harmful. And therefore we limit the quantity of entrapped air up to 4 to 5%, normally in normal conventional concrete having density 2400 kg per meter cube. I am just comparing here the properties of conventional concrete to make you understand what is difference between lightweight concrete and the conventional normal concrete, which is typically used many sites, and which is conventional, which is very conventional. And we have also seen the thermal properties through transient state and Seatherm analyzer, and we have seen that for grade 2.5 means, like we denoted as M20 or M25 for conventional concrete. Here M will not work. Here the G will work. So G2.5 CFC, and G3.5 CFC, and we have compared the properties, different properties which are related to thermal behavior with brick. And you can see here the density was just half for G3.5 and quite less for 2.5, and you just see the thermal conductivity, because we have more concern about thermal conductivity. So the normally the brick has the thermal conductivity value ranging from 0.65 to 0.80, and the concrete, the thermal conductivity of concrete ranges from 2 to 2.5 or 2.75. It depends on the amount of aggregate added, and the rock type, whether it is sandstone or marble stone or it is granite. So because in limestone the pores is quite less than that of sandstone. So if the pores is more, then the thermal conductivity will be less for aggregate, and which will overall will imparts the thermal conductivity of concrete. Because as you know that in concrete approximately 60 to 65% of coarse aggregate is there normally, typically. So it imparts indirectly the overall thermal conductivity of concrete. Like for CND waste concrete, like our colleague Dr. Santa Kumar have mentioned that it has adhered mortar, so it can imparts the lower thermal conductivity of that concrete mass as compared to a conventional concrete. So our main aim should be a lower thermal conductivity, and you can see here that for brick it is 1.72 and for lightweight concrete it was just half. So and it fulfilled the our aim, overall aim. And if you will see the macrostructural properties, we have seen that when we replaced the fine aggregate with the 100% of stone slurry, the intensity was more as compared to control conventional concrete, that is no stone slurry. And the CSH is the major phase which is generated in the cementitious system and causes the and imparts the major imparts the 7 days and 28 days strength properties in the cementitious system. So we have seen that CSH was formed more in case of 100% replacement, and that's why compressive strength for 100% replacement was more as compared to 0% replacement. If you will see the microstructure, you can see here in the left figure that early age porous CSH was formed, but in the right figure you can see that the CSH formed was densified. So therefore the strength was very high, and AFT phase was more in case of 100% replacement level of stone slurry. Generally what it happens when C3A, which is the alumina phase of cementitious system, when reacts with gypsum, it forms ettringite, which is denoted as AFT. And if the gypsum depleted, if enough amount of gypsum is not there, then that AFT, C3A converts into AFM phase. But when we add calcium carbonate, the calcium carbonate reacts with AFM and generates AFT again. The formation of ettringite will takes place again, and apart from AFT there will be formation of two other kind of phases, that is AFMC, that is monocarboaluminate, and hemicarboaluminate. Although the solubility of calcium carbonate is quite low, the solubility product of calcium carbonate is quite low. It is like if you will add 100 gram of calcium carbonate, then only 20% of calcium carbonate will dissolve and will take part into the reaction. So the formation of hemicarbonate and AFMC phase will be there, and which stabilize the AFT phase, as you can see in the right part. So overall the conclusion was we have started by taking the water cement ratio of 0.604 control mix. However, we have casted we have taken the water cement ratio less than 0.60, but and we have achieved the overall good strength, but the workability and the flowability was quite less. So we have not chosen the water cement ratio less than 0.60 in normal concrete. What we take the water cement ratio typically like 0.40 about, and the maximum strength performance factor, that is compressive strength, was 382 and 318 at water cement ratio of 0.860, and it was achieved with the 50% replacement of sand, sand having fineness modulus of 1.07. Now, what I have mentioned, this fineness modulus, normally, if you will see the table which is given in IS 383, there are four kind of zones. But we have taken the river sand, that is Solani river sand, which has fineness of 1.07, because as per British Cement Association, the sand what we want to add to develop lightweight concrete should have fineness less than 1.25. Therefore, we have chosen the river sand, very fine river sand, and the stone slurry of course have fineness 335 meters square per kg, which is quite more than that of cement. And as you know that the cement has fineness typically has about 260 to 265 or 270, with minimum 225 meters square per kg as per IS 8112 code. And generally it is not recommended to replace 100% replacement of stone slurry powder, because the packing density will be quite less, and filler effect of course will be not, because void ratio will be increased, and as you know that packing density is related with void ratio. More void ratio, less packing density, and as a coefficient of thermal expansion was found as per ACI 523 third revision for both kind of series, that is S1 and S2, and thus the use of stone slurry flare as presented is not only beneficial to concrete industry but also friendly to environment, because in this case we can replace 50% of natural sand. Now I will tell you briefly what property we have achieved, and as compared to brick, and what should be there as per IS 2185 part 4. The dry density, of course, it was in the range of 825 to 1050. Our target range was, of course, 800 to 1000 kg per meter cube. So error was too less. We have our mixed design was such that we have achieved the exact target density, nearly exact target density what we want to achieve. And as you are aware that normally class 1, class 2, class 3 types of bricks have density of 1900 to 2000 kg per meter cube. The compressive strength of the developed block was ranged from 3.75 to 5.75, which was at par as compared to the compressive strength which is given in the IS code, and of course compared with brick, the thermal conductivity was quite less, and as compared to brick, and which was as per standard which is given in IS code. Water absorption was as compared to brick was nearly same, and cost, this is main issue for industrialist and entrepreneurs. So you can see that cost was just half. Why this just half? Because overall in lightweight concrete production, the amount of the cement was ranged from 15 to 17%, and the rest of the amount was that is 80 to 85% was waste, just waste, with the addition of some amount of river sand. Therefore, the cost of the lightweight blocks were reduced, but in brick you know that the cost of soil is quite high, and in the many area it is banned also to extract to mine the soil, and also after that we have to add fuel to burn that one, and electricity cost will be there. So that's why overall cost was quite less as compared to brick. Here, as I have already discussed in detail, the advantage I have mentioned here as raw material was cement, waste, sand in case of CFC block what we have developed, and it was quite eco-friendly. Energy consumption was quite less. We can handle these blocks with ease, and the finishing and uniformity was quite high, because it depends on us. Whatever we desire, we can give the shape of CFC because it has higher flowability. Electricity consumption, of course, was low, and just to run the foam generator and mixer, just to run that one, while it was quite high in case of brick production, and the workability during and after production was very very good, because we can drill these blocks, we can nail, and this block can easily shown. But you can't cut brick. If you want to do the two half of brick, then you just to break by some cutter or and something else. But this lightweight blocks, you just cut by normal saw. Apart from lightweight concrete products, however, I have not covered the other kind of building products. Our team has developed different kinds of building products, such as flooring tiles as per IS 1237, paver blocks as per IS 15658, and of course lightweight blocks, that you can see in the last row of top right figure. We have developed also, and these building products was dimensionally stable, cost effective and durable. Application wise, floor tiles have used can be used for light traffic loads and heavy traffic loads. Paver blocks, we have developed the strength ranging from M30 to M55, so you can use those paver blocks for non-traffic and for heavy traffic also, depending on standard axle that is given on the table in IS 15658. And CFC blocks, of course, you can use the CFC material for infill and brick replacement. And all these developed products has been implemented in the our demo houses, and for payment, you can see here that we have implemented these developed products for demonstration purpose. And important parameters: the size of tiles was 1 feet by 1 feet, and the size of CFC block was 400 by 200 by 200 mm, and you can cut it also as per requirement easily. Wet transfer strength of tiles was ranges from 4.50 to 6.50. normally it should be more than 3 MPa, which is as per IS 12537. And compressive strength of CFC block, of course, was ranges from 4 to 7 MPa. And paver blocks, as I have already told, range from M30 to M50 with varying thickness of 50 to 100 mm. And after we have done cost economics analysis, and we have seen that the profitability as compared to commercial tiles, paver blocks and CFC blocks was approximately 35 to 45% on annual turnover. Here you can see briefly what we have done. You just see the selling cost. So here CBRI, the tiles, flooring tiles, wall tiles, paver blocks, CFC blocks, etc., the cost is given for unit as well as for square meter, and the same is given for same dimension for commercial tiles. So you can see that for CFC block, the overall cost was reduced up to 45 to 50%. So after conducting comprehensive detailed research study in our group, we have conducted the industrial meets in the past in the various region of Rajasthan, in the Ramganj Mandi, Kota, and in CBRI itself, also in Jaipur. And we have demonstrated, we have presented our building products that we have developed from stone waste. And after after demonstration, of course, they have admired our technology, and finally, in the year 2017, that technology entitled building product using Kutastone waste has been transferred to RSPCB Jaipur, and after transferred technology, the MOU have been signed for future collaboration, and for we have also demonstrated the technology at our lab in our CBRI, and also the all over the detail that further you want to know is given in on this YouTube URL. So you can just see this URL. So the detailed description of the technology is given on this YouTube URL. After transfer of technology, the setting plant, that was India's first setting startup plant for Kutastone waste management, which was recognized by center and state government under startup policy and Swachh Bharat Abhiyan, has been started in Kota on 16th June, and here in the right you can see the inauguration of that pilot plant, and this plant has capacity of 8000 flooring tiles, 3500 rough pavers, and 5000 bricks daily from Kutastone waste, and it can utilize the capacity is so much that it can utilize up to 100 ton of Kutastone per day. Now briefly, very briefly, 3-4 slides are I will tell you that what ongoing work we are doing, and for the academic persons and industrialists and whoever wants to collaborate with us in our group, that is now, right now we are not only focusing on cellular form concrete from stone waste, but also we are also focusing to develop autoclave aerated concrete from waste. Also we are developing structural lightweight concrete having strength more than 50 to 20 MPa, and which can be used as floor screed for structural purpose also. So just 3-4 slide I will tell you very briefly. So we are using LISA. We are not using normal aggregate. We are not using normal aggregate. We are using LISA, lightweight expanded clay aggregate, and they are of course hard, and they are hard and honeycombed structure because they are formed after sintering of clay, and ECA is 100% inert, vitrified, and dimensionally stable, and they are frost and fire resistance, and thermal. They have property of thermal insulation and sound absorption. Sound absorbent behavior they have, and they have pores in the amount of ranging from 25 to 50%. So they are quite porous, and the size we are using, it ranges from 0 to 15 mm. And we are replacing not only fine sand, but we are also replacing coarse sand to develop lightweight structural concrete. So these are raw materials what we are using right now, and physical properties is given here for lightweight concrete. You can see here normally the density of conventional aggregate has bulk density quite much more than the lightweight aggregate. See here, if you will take the size ranges from 2 to 8 mm, the bulk density is only 430 kg per meter cube, which is quite less. To develop structural lightweight concrete, we have conducted several trials to optimize percentage of LISA to be added for packing density, to increase the packing density, to decrease the void ratio, to optimize the water cement ratio after taking after adding the super plasticizer for desirable slump value. We have optimized for OPC also. Our aim was to reduce the OPC content by incorporating fly ash up to amount of 5 to 35%. So for that we have done casting, testing, and then our main purpose was to optimize for hue value. As you can see here, if you will see the ECBC code, which is Energy Conservation Building Code, revised version, which has been published in 2017, for composite climate, like in Roorkee area, is comes in composite climates. So our main target was to achieve the U value of 0.40. So till now we have achieved the U value of 0.31 watt per meter square Kelvin. And right now we are doing we are targeting to reduce down it more. So this is the future scope. To whom? Those wants to work with our group, those who wants to collaborate with us, academic persons, students, and industrialists, to carry out the motto Waste to Wealth, a way forward. A few future scopes are intensive assessment of rheological measurements are yet to be done to characterize fresh formed concrete on the basis of flow characteristics. Advanced microstructural study by incorporating different inorganic mixes, matrices like polymers, thermosetting polymers with stone waste in cement concrete. It is yet to be done freeze thaw resistance study on the basis of air void spacing factors, because while studying freeze thaw resistance, it should be emphasis given on air void spacing factor, and then use of formed concrete as a sandwich composite panel with normal weight concrete, and then study of slurry as sustainable fillers in polymer matrices. I want to acknowledge my group leader, Dr. Mrs. Rajni Lakhani, who is head of organic building materials group, and along with that Mr. Sanawaj Khan and Neha Rawat, who supported in this research study to carry out casting and physico-mechanical study.